Thank you, Dipanjan, for taking me in the team of the IC
Share your
for the
screen.
basics. And thank you, Ayers, for calling me.
Share your screen, Sumita.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
Topic was well given today. How do I select my patients for trabeculectomy? This is a very tricky one in this area. But the first thing I want to share, the decision for surgery should consider the risk and the benefit ratio, because the risk the patient has to take and the doctor has to take, and the benefit the patient is to gain from the trabeculectomy. So these are the two you have to take the decision, which one is better for the patient. So why trabeculectomy? Because it is found that the maximum medical therapy or the laser surgery fails to lower the target IOP. Everything that is a target IOP. If it fails, we can go for the next stage is the surgery. And that's the trabeculectomy. That's the gold standard still yet. Another thing I found is the irregularity and the compliance with the medicines applied. Many patients, there's a big number of patients, this compliance is there. For these patients, I try to convince them to go for the surgery. Coming to the cost. The cost is a variable now because the indigenous is a cheaper medication of the prostaglandin available. The patient pressure controls is there and the field is also maintained. The cost is not a matter. But in some cases, cost is matters for some patients who cannot afford it. For those patients, I try to go for the trabeculectomy. This comes the side effects of the drugs. This is a very important. Many find lots of side effects of the patient in each and every day, many patients. So in these cases, it's better to go for the trabeculectomy to avoid the side effects of the drugs. At the polypharmacy, not a single drug is being used, maybe two, three, four drugs is being used. And all these are polypharmacies for the drug and also for the preservative. There is lots of side effects, dryness and other. In these cases, if the patient cannot afford it, cannot maintain the polypharmacy, we can go for the trabeculectomy. And the last thing, what I want to say that first you have to understand the disease. Make the patient understand, make the patient and the party understand the disease before going for the surgery. So they have to understand what that glaucoma is. Next is the progression of the glaucoma. Progression is the main treatment is the quality of life has to be maintained. If you find any that compromise, we have to turn for the trabeculectomy. And even if we find the structural and the functional say changes is there in spite of the pressure is standard with the medicine, I go for the trabeculectomy. Then for the stages of the disease, what are stages? Is the moderate, mild, moderate, or the advanced? If the patient is advanced stage and the patient has lots of complications, the senior is or the comorbidities and they cannot afford it or something else of that, in these types of cases, I sometimes go for the trabeculectomy. Even in the early, younger patient with the advanced stages, I prefer to go for the trabeculectomy because it gives a more standardized, except the complications. Age of the patient, what I was talking, the patient with the younger age for the long life has to be taken, or the young, old age, the shorter lifespan. This has to be taken into account before going for the trabeculectomy because the progression is the glaucoma. Once it occurs, it's sometimes it's very difficult to stop it with the drugs. So maybe trabeculectomy helps. And how rapid it is progressing. In some cases, in low tension glaucoma, normal tension glaucoma, the rapidity of the, even if the patient is low teeth, you can go for the trabeculectomy. In the left side, because this is a field testing, it started in the 2014, still in the 2020, it looked the standard. There's a rate of progression listed. It hasn't deteriorated or slight changes in that. In these cases, no, wait. But in the right side, if I go, it was a preoperative, is it January, the March date, after that, I did go for that trabeculectomy. This is a one-eyed patient with this small field of vision is the irregular medication. And to my surprise, after 3 months, when I did the field testing, the field increased. It may be due to the learning curve. I don't know. But in this sense, you have to take the risk and benefit for the patient. We have already wanted the target of one eye, but you have to look for the other eye because sometimes we miss the other eye for the progression. So what stage of the patient is going on to the other eye is also look for before I try for the doing for the trabeculectomy. And the family history of blindness has to be taken care of. And primary surgery is still debatable. In my cases, in some patient, if I can go for the counseling, if I found the patient and the party not listening or not understanding the type of disease, and for the long run, they won't come for the follow-on, I try to convince them for the surgery. Maybe I'm taking the risk and benefit of the patient. Thank you.